And then with the wise to consort. So who are the wise? The wise is the converse of the foolish. That is, wise people are those who believe in karma, who understand the Dhamma, who are practicing the way to lead them to a good rebirth. That means either rebirth in heaven, or if not, at least the human realm, and not going to the woeful plains. So if you associate with the wise, then you will learn the Dhamma from the wise people, and then you will learn to practice the Dhamma, and you will not regret it in the end. Life, actually, the Buddha said, life is suffering, dukkha. Actually, dukkha and sukha is just two sides of a coin. It's just a black and white. If you have white, you must have black. If you have black, you must have white. They come together, they come in a pair, good and bad. So, suffering and happiness. So, you see, people like fools, they want to have happiness, and the greed for happiness is so strong that they forget about all other things, and they just want to enjoy themselves, even to the extent of harming other people. They dare to do because their ego, they're self-centered. They want to benefit themselves only. So in the end, they have to suffer. So they enjoy first, and then they suffer in the end. Whereas people who practice the Dhamma, they are willing to forego some of the happiness, and even take on a bit of suffering initially, because the end result is happiness, right? People like monks, we are willing to forego some of our worldly happiness and in a way suffer a bit more material-wise compared with worldly people, because we know in the end we will have more happiness than worldly people. So you have to choose whether you want happiness first or you want happiness in the end.